I was picked out because it's the media. The media always presents Middle East. You never get, you know, a little liberal man in a suit talking. Every time the news says, and now to get a balanced view of the Middle East, we now go to Muslim nutcase with a hook. Nutcase, just stand still for a second. We're outside Finsbury Park Mosque here. Nutcase, tell us your thoughts. When I believe death to America, I'm going to blow myself up right now. Death to Les Dennis, death to Pauline Quirk, death to all BBC sitcoms. I'm going to kill myself right now. Well, there you have it. There's the voice of the Middle East. Here's Michael Fish with the weather. Not to put too fine a point, it's a bit like Al Jazeera saying, and now to get a balanced view of the Christian West, we now go to the Grand Dragon of the Ku Klux Klan. Well, thank you, Mohammed. We believe in death to all darkies, Jews, and Arabs everywhere. We believe in creating a white supremacist state in the middle of Egypt with its headquarters in Arkansas with the Lord Jesus with the burning cross going, yee-haw, boy, yee-haw. Well, there you have it. There's the voice of the Christian West. Here's Fatima with the sport.
This is a Fox News alert. Things are getting more bizarre in Geneva, Switzerland, where Iranian President Mahmoud Ahmadinejad is at the microphones right now speaking. This is a conference on racism. Apparently Ahmadinejad using the occasion to engage in racism himself, calling Israel a racist government. Both Israel and Canada's representatives have just got up and walked out. Now, not just that, but we're told that there are protesters up in the balcony right now who are shouting at him. They're trying to get control over those two folks. And look at this. Wearing clown hair, decided to go up and make his protest known. Also not a fan of Ahmadinejad.
They have forged a regime through collecting people from various parts of the world and bringing them to other people's land by displacing, detaining, and killing the true owners of that land. The Security Council cannot do anything, and sometimes, under pressure from a few bullying powers, even paves the way for supporting these Zionist murderers. The lives, properties, and rights of the people of Georgia and Ossetia and Abkhazia are victims of the tendencies and provocations of NATO and certain Western powers, and the underhanded actions of the Zionists. I thank you all very much.
On behalf of the General Assembly,
I wish to thank His Excellency, the President of the Islamic Republic of Iran, and request the representatives to remain seated while I greet the President.
Iran says he wants to wipe Israel off the face of the earth.
He didn't say that, and you know very well he didn't say that. He said he wanted Zionism to be wiped off the page of history. Well, just like he said, Nazism and communism. When you wanted to wipe out communism, you didn't want to wipe out Russia. You didn't want to wipe out the Russian people. This was a political statement.
We مشکلی نداری.
Have no problems with Jewish people.
الان یهودی ها در ایران زندگی میکنن.
There are many Jews who live in Iran today. Please pay attention to the fact that the Zionists are not Jewish people.
اونها دین ندارن.
They have no religion.
اونها دین ندارن.
They have no religion.
نه یهودی هن.
They're neither Jews.
نه مسیحی هن.
Nor Christians.
نه مسلمان.
Nor Muslims.
اونها ماسک دین زدن.
They just have wear a mask of religiosity. How can you possibly be religious and occupy the lands of other people? How can you call yourself a religious person and kill women and children?
The Zionists, as you call them, do they not come from some history of persecution? Do they not come from the deaths of millions of men, women and children? Is there not a birth, no birth in that? You don't think that happened?
You see, first and foremost, they just simply don't allow anyone to freely discuss the history that happened. Where did it happen? Did it happen in Palestine? Or did it happen in Europe? If the crimes were committed in Europe, why should the Palestinian people be victimized as a result? All right, in Europe, why don't the Europeans just give them a territory? Or in Alaska, perhaps. They can give them a territory anywhere they like. But why pay from the pocket of some other people? It's as if somebody throw a party from the pocket of someone else. The Palestinian people had no role in that crime. They're innocent completely.
Token of gratitude for the sweetness and love you have extended to Jews and all mankind. On behalf of World Torah Jewry, presented by Nature Character International, New York, USA.
The president is of the world leaders who is exemplary in his comprehension and understanding totally the difference between Judaism, the spirituality, the religion, the servitude, and subservience to God, and the antithetical concept of Zionism, which is a materialism, godless in its essence, and a goal just for nationalism, and which is something forbidden clearly and distinctly by the Torah.
I was in Iraq 3 days before the bombs fell in 91. There were Muslim Sunni mosques. There were Shia mosques. There were Christian churches and Jewish temples and synagogues. Even under Saddam Hussein, there was peace among them. Isn't that right, Brother Baghdadi? But when America went in, under the guise that he had weapons of mass destruction, did they find any? So what was shock and awe about? You want to bring Gaddafi before the International Criminal Court? What about Bush? What about Rumsfeld? What about a government that lied to the American people and caused the lives of hundreds of thousands to be lost? I am not a hater of the Jewish people. But I know the truth.
Whenever government wants you to think and act in a certain way, that would bring justification to an action that they are already planning to make. They must make the person that they hate a boogeyman. Mm-hmm. They're dissatisfied. Well, what is their dissatisfaction about? Do they have jobs? Yes. Do they have food? Yes. Has Gaddafi used the oil money to build Libya? Yes. Did Gaddafi use oil money and discover water under the Sahara Desert and brought that water to the surface? Did he impose farming in the desert so that they could feed their own people? Yes. Are there billions of dollars that he's spending building homes, building apartments for his people? Yes. So something is under this. When you look the other way, when the Israeli Defense Force was bombing the innocent people of Gaza, unarmed men, women, and children, but our government looked the other way. You looked the other way when the Israeli Defense Force went into Lebanon thinking that they were going to have an easy victory. Then you had to come out with your tail between your legs. Don't tell me and wise black people or white people that you're interested in black suffering. Where were you in Rwanda? Where are you in the Congo? Why did you go to Darfur? Because oil is there. No, you don't want to save the Libyan people. That's your noble motive to hide your wicked agenda.
If we start bombing and shelling and threatening to invade his country, you can be sure he'll fight back.
So is that a reason not to do it? Because
yes,
we fear
of course
it retribution.
Is. Well, but, why are we doing it, Anna? We're a country that can't even pay our bills. We're almost bankrupt. We're laying off hundreds of thousands of people. We can't keep our pensioners warm in the winter. How come we've got money to go to war after war after war in the interests of oil companies and arms companies? That's what people in Britain are asking themselves this morning. Well, it's the double standards that get me. There's more people being gunned down, innocent protesters, in Yemen, for example. And no one would dream of invading or imposing a no-fly zone on Yemen because Yemen doesn't have oil. It's so transparently an attempt to protect British companies and other Western companies' massive investments in Libya that it is discredited in the Arab world. I saw your package saying there are Arab representatives at this meeting. Who are these Arab representatives? They can't even name themselves or the countries that they come from.
But we know that the Arab League came out publicly and backed the UN resolution.
But the Arab League is a collection of dictatorships.
So we shouldn't be dealing with Arab nations, is
what
you're saying.
No, but don't pray them in aid of an operation that's supposed to be standing up for human rights and democracy. The Arab League, without exception, is a collection of puppet presidents, corrupt kings, every one of them a dictator. Every one of them now currently shooting their own people who are demonstrating for
democracy.
Well, that's
right, but what's the alternative? Do we stand by and watch Colonel
Gaddafi
killing
his
people?
But we are standing by watching.
But we're preparing to
attack. We're standing by watching the Yemen president killing his people. We're standing by watching the Bahrain king killing his people. So what's the difference between them and Libya? Everyone watching this knows the difference is a dirty little three-letter word called oil.